Each matrix below represents the augmented matrix for a system of linear equations. Determine whether there is one solution, infinitely many solutions, or no solution. Notice each augmented matrix is a 3x4 matrix, which indicates each augmented matrix represents a system of three equations with three unknowns. If the variables are x, y, and z, then the first column represents the coefficients of x, the second column represents the coefficients of y, the third column represents the coefficients of z, and the fourth column represents the constants on the right side of each equation. Each row represents an equation. For example, this first row represents the equation -4x plus 10y minus 6z equals 131. One way to determine whether there is one solution, infinite solutions, or no solution is to write each augmented matrix in reduced row echelon form, which for review, I've defined here on the right. All these conditions must be met in order for an augmented matrix to be in reduced row echelon form. This lesson is not going to focus on how to write an augmented matrix in reduced row echelon form. It will focus only on interpreting the final results. You may be performing row operations by hand to write the augmented matrices in reduced row echelon form, or you may be using technology. Either way, here are the three augmented matrices in reduced row echelon form. Let's focus on the first augmented matrix in reduced row echelon form. The important thing to remember is that each row represents an equation. For example, this first row represents the equation 1x equals negative 2.1, or x equals negative 2.1. The second row represents 1y equals 7.1, or y equals 7.1. And the third row represents the equation z equals negative 8.6. This indicates there is one solution, and the system can be classified as consistent and independent. And now let's take a look at the second augmented matrix in reduced row echelon form. And let's focus on this third row. Notice here we have an entire row of zeros, which is an equation, would simply be 0 equals 0. 0 equals 0 is always true, which indicates the system has an infinite number of solutions, and the system can be classified as consistent and dependent. And then finally, let's look at the last augmented matrix in reduced row echelon form. And again, let's focus on this last row. We have 0, 0, 0, 1, which is an equation, would be 0 equals 1. We know 0 equals 1 is not true. This indicates the system has no solution, and we can classify the system as inconsistent. I hope you found this helpful.